Hello friends, I have been receiving so many phone calls from my students located in different parts of the country regarding how to strategize the examination preparation because of the confusion caused by the postponement of prelims examination. So this is why I am making a video to strategize your 120 days from today. This is not a very unprecedented situation, the postponement of prelims examination, because in the 2020, we had this postponement of prelims. What you have to essentially learn from the 2020 postponement experience is that many students who were very sincerely preparing for this examination, because of the postponement of the examination, they had a very sluggish preparation thereafter and they could not clear the examination. On the contrary, some students who were very, very passive in their preparation grabbed the grace period given by the postponement of the examination and they were able to seize the opportunity, studied very studiously, and they cleared the examination. So we have a very important lesson. Postponement of examination, on one hand, is an opportunity for students to fast track their preparation and clear the examination. At the same time, it is also a very difficulty that it gives a little bit of sluggishness in their preparation as they think that they have more time. So try to utilize the opportunity and study well for the examination. Now this video essentially is to give you the strategy for the next 120 days to prepare for your examination. 120 days, which is roughly 4 months. We have 4 months at our disposal. June, July, August, and September. So what we are going to do in this 4 months, that is going to decide your next 40 years. We have to prepare for the main examination as well, because in the last year, similar to this year, the prelims examination was held in October and the main examination was held in the first week of January. So which means that students were having less than 100 days for their mains preparation. And if you postpone this mains preparation, keep it for after prelims, you will be overloaded that time. We will not be able to complete the syllabus. So I wanted you to give some time adequately during this 4 months period to prepare for your main examination as well. There are four important things which you have to do in this 4 months time period. Number one, you have to continue with your prelims preparation. You don't forget prelims preparation. You have to take prelims preparation along with your mains preparation, and that would be the effective strategy. Take first prelims, then the second component is mains. Here, main examination syllabus is like an ocean. So what we can do is small dosage of mains you have to give into your preparation. Small dosage, because unnecessarily it will cause tension, it will overload your preparation. I don't want to overload your preparation. So in a very easy way, you have to carry forward this mains weightage as well. So what you are going to do is this, that mains I am putting into two different segments. You have already one prelims portions. Secondly, mains I am splitting into two different segments. One is NCERT mains. It will be very surprising for many of you that I am speaking about NCERT for mains, because most of these students think that NCERT is good only for prelims. But through my experience, I come to know that you have nice points given in the NCERT books for your mains answers. Not just about the nice points, it's about the articulation of the points in a very, very expressive way. You can take clue from the NCERT books. So two components I have told for mains. One is NCERT mains. You have to read mains from NCERT point of view, or you have to read NCERT from mains point of view. And secondly, the most visually ignored portions in the mains called as ethics paper. When you study for your prelims, you are studying anyhow polity, you are studying history, you are studying economics, you are studying science and technology, you are studying environmental science, everything you are studying, whatever is there for the main examination in the form of prelims, at least the fundamentals. But what you are missing totally in the mains, in the prelims preparation is main, in the prelims preparation is your ethics paper. So I wanted you to give weightage to ethics paper now, right? So ethics paper you have to complete in this next 4 months. You have to complete NCERT mains. Already I have told about prelims. So prelims, NCERT mains, ethics. And fourthly, your optional. Optional is very, very essential for us to secure the dream service office. Because you know it is a trump card that it will take you to the service you aspire for. And you have to finish the optionals as well. You have to finish both the papers of your optional. So, in the 4 months time period, that is June, July, August, September, I am telling you to cover 4 important components. One is prelims, second is NCERT mains, third is ethics mains, and fourth is your optional. Now here, a very important question comes over. How will I be able to take all the 4 things together? Here where I am telling you to go for alternate week strategy. What do you mean by this alternate week strategy? Every week you are going to study only 2 things. Take for example, June 1st week and June 2nd week. June 1st week you are studying 2 out of the 4 components which I have told. For example, June 1st week, polity, prelims, right? And secondly, NCERT mains. So prelims and NCERT mains will be done in week 1. Then in the second week, you are doing the other 2 components, that is optional and ethics paper. So week 1, prelims and NCERT mains. Week 2, optional and ethics. Week 3, again, prelims and NCERT main. Week 4, optional and your ethics paper. So, in this way, if you take up your studies, you will be able to cover substantially your prelims as well as your mains. A detailed micro plan is provided in the description of this video. You download the PDF of the description. You download the PDF given in the description to get the micro management plan. We have given the micro management plan in the form of mains test series, prelims test series, simply integrated test series. So test series is not to test what you have studied. Test series is to properly make you study. Because without test, we will find little bit lesser motivation to prepare. So it is through the test we are making you study. And therefore, click on to the PDF link which I have given in the description, which will contain the entire test series timetable, which is nothing but your study timetable. My dear friends, achievement is not a matter of luck. Achievement is not a matter of luck. Achievement is really a science. Individual differs. Individual, each and every individual differs. But the same law of success applies to all. What you reap is what you sow. This examination system demands something from you. Without giving that thing into the system, you cannot get what you wanted from the system. You cannot get out of life what you are not willing to give into life. We should understand this very clearly. What is needed by this examination system? This examination system requires hard work, perseverance, and self-belief. So you put into these 3 things into this examination system, you'll get what you wanted, that is success in the civil services examination. Have tangible plan of action. Measure your action. Because without the measurement of your action, you cannot manage your action. You cannot modify your action. So, don't try to lead a life with so much of assumptions. Clear away all your assumptions. Ignite your enthusiasm. Prepare well for the examination. Definitely, life will give what you wanted from life. The best of your life you will be able to get if you give your best to this examination. All the very best. Thank you.